Welcome back to H20 Special Relativity. So moving from special relativity to general relativity, we relax the requirement that reference frames can only have a constant relative velocity to each other. So we are looking at what happens now if we have accelerating reference frame. And the first example is that of gravitational time dilation. So imagine you are in have a device which has two clocks. And so the first clock sends its ticks up in terms of light beeps or beams with some specific frequency. So there's a transmission going on and there's a receiver on the other side. And the clock, the upper clock, U clock, submits the same thing. They both have the same frequency. Let's say 10 pulses per tick. We also assume that now that we don't have to consider special relativity effects here. So the velocity of this thing is very small. Okay, so relativistic effects are small. But when I now accelerate this device, there is an interesting effect. The lower clock will receive more than 10 pulses per tick. So it's perceived as running slow from the upper clock, right? So the lower clock is expecting 10 ticks, but it's seeing 12. So you think that your clock is running slow. Similarly, you can discuss the upper clock, which because it's accelerating upwards, it only receives 8 pulses per tick. So it's expecting 10, so it's perceives to be faster. Now, this acceleration, as in this example, as I discussed previously, is equivalent to being in a gravitational field. So we have a time dilation effect on Earth. We already discussed the consequence in the discussion of GPS systems. Here is a summary of this plot and just showing you the effect of changing gravitational fields as a function as of the distance of the center of the Earth. And you see that the gravitational speed up zero on the Earth's surface becomes rather large as further away you get from Earth. While if you consider that this object, a satellite, is in an orbital motion, the speed of this object is kind of compensating partially. But there is this net effect, as we discussed earlier, on the GPS system.